please. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning once again. I don't want to go on the stage because I'm representing all of you as a moderator. And anyhow, working for a not-for-profit, okay, there's a lot of market cap there. And I want to sit on this side and look at from a not-for-profit angle. Be sure we invest in the first 10 minutes. Let me start with you. We are talking about emerging markets, and we are talking about retaining emerging markets. Just now, our host said that 300 million consumers. People have actually seen emerging market. Actually, you yourself are an emerging market. Okay, because 300 million consumers. You are seeing consumers of yesterday, today, and actually you are working for consumers of tomorrow because you call your group as future group. What are the changes you have seen in the last 10 years in the consumers? Where is the Indian consumer today compared to what you saw 10 years back?
Fashion as a business, I believe fashion as a business is taking shape now, because I believe there has been I'm seeing a trend wherein people are wanting to buy two times or three times a year of fashion. Even, and this is going deep down. If you look at the food habits, I think it's significantly changing. I was just discussing with Amit, and I was telling him the kind of growth we are seeing in the frozen French fries alone is more than 100% plus, and we are seeing it month on month growth. So, and he's seeing that impact in his stores, wherein we are able to sell French fries, which is consumed at home at 10 rupees, and he's still selling at 30 rupees. So, I think these are differences which we are going to see in many, many things. And I believe the next 10 years is going to be much, much more interesting than the past 10 years which has happened. And we are seeing a change everywhere. In fact, we are reimagining ourselves on how should the new Big Bazaar would be. And you might be surprised that Big Bazaar is changing absolutely in every which way, and we won't be a sabse sasta and acha.
Sabse sasta and acha, but you will be sabse acha.
We are changing our baseline. In fact, it's one of the big changes which we are doing ourselves.
It amazes me, Kishore, that every time two of us in the industry without you are talking, and we keep wondering ki yaar ye kya ho raha industry mein, suddenly you come and give an answer. I and Amit were talking about what's happening to the Indian market, why is consumption degrowth. And he was saying that, you know, after seeing 30, 40, 50% growth, it's no more 30, 40%, just large single digits. And French fries are actually not selling. And Kishore comes and tells because people are buying French fries from Big Bazaar. Yeah? Amit, being in the market, although you operate McDonald's within the country, but you get an access to what's happening to McDonald's in the developed market and also in the emerging markets. How are you seeing the change? And I was told by somebody a year back that Indian McDonald's is probably the fastest growing McDonald's across the world in terms of the same store growth, in terms of number of stores and what you're doing. What do you see happening in the emerging markets, especially from retail? And how do you see India compared to the emerging markets worldwide?
I think generally India has done extremely well, at least until the last year. So the growth that we saw, I think across all sort of players in the Indian market, whether it's pizza players, whether it's us, whether it's say Yums or whoever, 30 to 40% was common. Now, different countries have had different issues at different times. And what I found, if I look at it over 3 to 5 years, I find Philippines, Thailand, Indonesia, China, and India are pretty much hitting the same sort of percentage growth. At some points, India has been higher, at some point, some other markets. So for example, last couple of years, we've seen a bit of a slowdown in the Indian market, but I'm seeing tremendous growth, especially in the Philippines and Indonesia.
When you say slowdown, it is 20% like to like.
Fortunately in India, and that still is loved by everybody else in the Western world.
Hold on for a minute. Let me do a quick check. How many retailers here are still seeing a 20% like-to-like growth? There's nobody from income tax, you can still raise your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many of you are seeing 10 to 20% like-to-like growth? How many of you are seeing 0 to 10% like-to-like growth? So there are still people seeing 10 to 20%, but please envy guys who see 30, 40% and say 20% is actually slowing down our growth. Sorry, Amit, please
continue. No, that's absolutely correct. And that's what my point is, that even when we go to regional meetings, they still say that, wow, you even at 20%, you're absolutely fantastic, so what are you crying about?
But tell me one thing, in your meetings that you have with your global partners or within India, have you ever considered a Big Bazaar French fry, frozen French fry being sold as competition?
No, not really. Actually, I see it as a tremendous thing for us because it finally grows the category. If people are recognizing French fries and they are consuming French fries at home, I feel that at the end of the day, eating out is a different category. So when they come and eat out at a restaurant, now there's a better chance that in every transaction we'll get a French fry sale. So it is complementary in my view in the medium to long term.
Amit, by the time I come back, I want you to imagine and tell me that 10 years down the line, what will be the equivalent of French fries being sold in India? Okay, because we have had hot French fries and we've had frozen French fries. So I'm just wondering, will there be a new form of French fries that will happen?
Yeah, sure.
Sanjeev, you, last 4 months, 5 minutes.
Can I urge people to drink soup?
Okay.
Or soup to buy from Big Bazaar.
Okay, you know, there was this question being asked saying that to the marketers and brand managers, hey guys, what are you doing with the 30-second commercials? I mean, if there are people from HUL, please remember, your boss sitting in an open forum is actually using these 2 seconds very productively. Guys, please buy soup. Sanjeev, you've been into various markets, Philippines, GCC countries, Bangladesh. Now you're looking at India fresh in the last 4 months, 5 months. Are you surprised by the way the Indian consumers are behaving? Are you astonished with the way the Indian youth is looking today? And will you be really surprised or shocked in the next 5 years' time, and are you seeing some changes which will happen, which will actually make us very different from other parts of the world?
No, I'm not surprised really, yeah, because I've been a D&D man, I've worked in various D&D markets, and I understand how the evolution happens. And just a while back, we were talking about maturity of the markets. I believe none of the categories, certainly in which we operate, is anywhere close to maturity. Even if we take a highly penetrated category like laundry, for instance, yeah? If you look at the way the category has evolved, we first had cottage soaps, then we had mechanized soaps, yeah? Then we converted them to a basic clean powder, and then when you wanted more whiteness, if I may take the liberty of using a brand, you would migrate a consumer to Rin, and then if you wanted stain removal, you had Surf Excel. That's not yet the end of the story, yeah? So you will, as soon as you have more people going in for washing machines, you will have Matic powders. Not only that, there will be more scope for liquids. And look at fabric conditioners. Fabric conditioners today, if you just benchmark with Vietnam, the market in India could grow by a factor of 30. Yeah, that's the scope. I'm not talking of Western Europe or America. So the scope is immense. None of our categories are mature. It's about penetration. Where penetration is high, we do consumption increase. Frequency of consumption, where the consumption is going up, there is huge opportunity to upgrade a consumer. Yeah? So I think if the country keeps growing at about 7-8%, what we have proved in the past and could be done in the future, the growth in private consumption would be dramatic and significant.
And you didn't mention about what's happening after the fabric conditioners, you know, because I was talking to a lady today and she said, you know, I bought a designer garment for 10,000 rupees and every time I send it to Presto, I actually pay 500 to 600 bucks for a wash. So actually that's also happening in a big way.
Absolutely. But may I tell the lady, there's a beautiful brand called Comfort.
Well, can I ask the RAI CEO to record every time the brand is getting exposed and please look at the TRPs and charge HUL. That's one way of making a little bit of money in the Tailors Association of India. But Kishore, when we look at this whole emerging market phenomenon, some places in some parts of the world, I think the government has played a very key role. In our country, we don't know which government will play a role and whether the government will play a role, whether it is central government, state government, or sometimes I'm talking of even the local government, the corporations. Do you believe that the government has a role to play? Or a few years back in one of the images forum, I'd asked Mr. Kamal Nath to say which ministry looks after retail. And he said, Nagesh, pray that no ministry ever looks after retail. Because the moment the ministry starts looking after retail, you're not going to work. So what do you think is the role of government in this whole nation building as far as retail is concerned?
I think, Nagesh, we are actually struggling with our past in terms of the Gandhian economy of not consuming at all. I think we have to get over from the guilt of consumption. I think the new generation is doing that. I think in India, we were all, when I was born up and brought up, I think it was, we were all trained not to consume anything. And I think somehow the government has to realize that consumption is equal to development. If you consume more, there will be more manufacturing, there will be more jobs, there will be more services. And once you are in market economy, consumption is the only way of development. I think this mindset the government has to bring in. Consumption is, in fact, taxed more in this country and savings are encouraged. India has a very high savings rate. Unfortunately, it's dropping now. I think we can do away with a savings rate of 20% also. We are in excess of 30%. So I think there is a scope of consumption out of there also. Overall, I believe consumption has to be encouraged and that's only government which can play a role in that. And the understanding of the government in how consumption drives economy is going to be very, very important. And government has to create a whole environment wherein they encourage anything which deals with consumption.
Sanjeev, you've been in various markets. Do you recollect of any legislation, any law, any facilitation which actually became a booster to the whole consumption in any country or without being specifically advisory role to a government of India? Do you see something that can happen? And let's not talk of FDI because it is controversial.
You know, the role of the government is to be create an enabling environment. Yeah? Is gone are the days when the government could on its own drive the economy. And we have seen very clearly that capitalism is the best way to allocate scarce resources. Yeah? And guys, you will understand I have to be a capitalist to run Hindustan Unilever. But that does not mean that capitalism is the way the capitalism is today is a cure for all ills. And that is where there is a big role to play on compassionate capitalism. I think what the government should do, lay down the framework, and we have great businessmen, a great business instinct amongst the Indians, create the framework and let the Indians run the business.
Let me do a quick poll of the audience. How many of you think that the government is creating an enabling environment for retail to grow? People who believe that the government is creating an enabling environment, please raise your hands. Oh! Anybody from the media here, please? One. Anybody else? This is the best opportunity for you to turn around and take a few pictures. Not a single hand raised. Yeah? We are not saying we are Aam Aadmi Party, but I think the Aam Aadmi is saying that, hey government, please do something about it.